Have you ever tried to decipher a secret message with a secret code? This can be a lot of fun provided you have the right code. However, if the code is wrong, then the whole message probably doesn't make any sense or will not work at all. Hi, Dovann here, and welcome to another episode of Week at a Glance, where we dive into a thoughtful summary of this week's Bible study guide. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this episode, we will talk about education in arts and sciences. I remember a time in my childhood years when my friends and I wrote each other messages using secret codes we invented ourselves. Most of the time, we used the letters of the Latin alphabet, but totally changed their value. So, for example, letter number 1 is replaced by letter number 5. So instead of writing A, we wrote E. At times, we also used the Hebrew alphabet or made our own symbols. What if someone tries to decipher it without knowing the secret code that we made? Then the message makes no sense and usually cannot be deciphered at all. The right code is the prerequisite for a meaningful result. It is similar when we deal with the principles of arts and sciences. The Christian perspective and worldview is the right code that gives it the real meaning. Now, here are the important points to remember for today's episode. Our first point is theism, the existence of God. In Christian education, it is very important to understand that we start with the right presupposition that God exists. In this episode, my goal is not to prove God's existence, but to remind you that this principle is where we should begin. This principle acknowledges that God is the creator of life. He is also the sustainer of life and the entire universe. He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. Not only did He bring them into being, but He also maintains them each moment. What happens if God, out of nowhere, decides to collect the breath of life? Then all flesh would perish together and man would return to dust. So if He were to recall the breath of life that He gave humans at creation, then all would perish. Because we live and breathe and move by His sustaining power. God as the creator and sustainer is a fundamental part of the puzzle of life. Different fields of arts and sciences have tried to solve many of life's biggest questions, but they often stumble with regards to origins. Now let's move on to the next point to talk about it. Our second point is creationism, the extraordinary design. The Bible tells us that creation has a creator. This creator is mentioned and glorified many times in the Bible. And one example is in Nehemiah. Nehemiah records the song of Israel during communal prayer. You alone are the Lord. You have made the heaven of heavens with all their host, the earth and all that is on it, the seas and all that is in them. You give life to all of them, and the heavenly host bows down before you. This creator is the master designer and the life giver. Everything that God made to be beautiful has been sadly perverted and exploited by God's enemy. Our expression of creativity has also been corrupted. Between arts and sciences, it is easy to blame science for the decline of morality and spirituality because of the introduction of the theory of evolution. But wait. Let's consider the arts. The role the arts play in our lives may not seem a priority, but when one thinks of how media and the arts are affecting the morality of our nation, the significance becomes clear. From this, we see how the field of arts has contributed to the spiritual and moral decline of humanity. Let's look at now the beauty of nature. There are so many breathtaking sceneries around the world. And from this, we get a glimpse of how the Creator loves beauty. Just try to imagine how nature looked like before the worldwide flood, or better yet, before the fall of Adam and Eve, that God even declared when He saw all that He had made, and behold, it was what again? It was very good. Nature, although distorted by sin, still reveals the Creator God. David speaks of God's glory as seen in His created works. The heavens are telling of the glory of God, and their expanse is declaring the work of His hands. If this is the case, then why does atheism not see the trace of God's hand in nature? This is because they start with the wrong presupposition. Now let's go to the next point to talk about it. Our third and final point is scientism, the experts in error. Science has helped us understand the world we live in. It has helped physicians cure sicknesses and extend human life. It has facilitated scientists to study the human body. It has also enabled engineers to create technology that makes it possible for you to be watching this video right now. The problem is not with science, but with scientism. Scientism is a philosophical position that claims that the methods of science are the only reliable source of knowledge and truth. It starts with the wrong presupposition that there is no God and rejects creation as unscientific. And where does this lead to? To a wrong conclusion. Listen to this. God has permitted a flood of light to be poured upon the world in both science and art. But when professedly scientific men treat upon these subjects from a merely human point of view, they will assuredly come to wrong conclusions. We have high regard for some scientists, for some philosophers, and some great artists, for their brilliance and contribution in the fields of arts and sciences. Yet from a Christian perspective, what does a knowledge of the arts and sciences really mean if it does not involve knowing the difference between right and wrong, between good and evil, between truth and error? Think of the scientists who are involved in making weapons of mass destruction, or think of some philosophers who have negatively impacted the world, like David Hume and Friedrich Nietzsche, who amongst others denied the existence of God. Without the existence of God, there is no standard and basis of morality. These are just a few examples of experts in error. In order to properly understand the riddle of life and to properly decipher the message, we must start with the right code. In the case of arts and sciences, this code is God as the creator of our earth. With this code, we can better understand arts and sciences and teach them from the Christian perspective and Christian worldview. In summary, here are the different points that we talked about in today's episode on education in arts and sciences. Point number one, theism, the existence of God. Point number two, creationism, the extraordinary design. And point number three, scientism, the experts in error. If you find this episode helpful, then share it with a friend. Spread the word and change lives one message at a time. And if you want to learn more about the church and education, then click on this video right here. This is again, Dovann for Week at a Glance. I'll see you again next week.